Hi. And welcome. In the following hour, we will talk about how to hack a femoto cell and how to intercept and hijack the data and all its command and all its communication. Here is the main content we will show you. But now, let me introduce ourselves first. We are from Unicorn team of Qihoo company, and we concentrate in radio and hardware research. We also design a lot of interesting gadgets. You may see them in the Windows region. Of course, we have a lot of talented team members. And my name is Yuwei Zheng. I'm interested in security and embedded system, and I'd like to deeply dig into some mystery system. And the BlackBerry is all of my task in 2011. And this is another speaker, Haoqi Shan.
Hi, everyone. A lot of people, so a little bit nervous. And my name is Haoqi Shan, and I'm just a wireless hardware security researcher in Unicorn team. And I just got just obtained my bachelor degrees of electronic engineering in this year. So a little bit useful while I'm hacking some embedded device and some electronic device. So I focus on the Wi-Fi hacking, the GSM systems, and some, your router, your switchers, and something else. And now let's take a look at this. So let's just focus on this. Why do we need a femoto cell? I believe you guys have seen the vehicle hacking at Black Hat just the day before yesterday. Well, just before, yeah. So once they just hacking it, if this vehicle is not in Wi-Fi, well, it will connect through the 3G, 3 generation or 2 generation. And so if you want to hack it, if you want to know what is going on, you need a femoto cell. That's very useful device. And besides, when you want to research on the products that integrated cellular modem, the femoto cell is the best choice that you ever have. And if you want to capture or hijack or modify the SMS, the voice, the data traffic, well, you need it. So maybe someone want to ask, why do you guys not just use a software-based GSM station, such as OpenBTS, USRP, or GNU Radio? So why not? Because if you want to, this software-based station can do the data traffic hijack, but if you want to know the SMS, if you want to modify the data traffic, well, you it's not okay, and it will access denied to the operator's core network, and well, it has no real uplink or downlink SMS, so you cannot hijack it. So, you can know that what's going on, what's going in, but you won't know what's going out. So this is a female. These are the femoto cell's advantage. So now you have the access to the network, to the network's core operator's core network. And well, if you hack it, well, you can know what's going on. You can know the all SMS and data traffic. Well, you can capture it, you can hijack it, you can modify it. What's more, now you have the ability to remain in the operator's network. You can just hack their switchers, you can hack their secure gateway, or you can, if you if you are cool, that you can hack basically everything. This is the interface that you can go in. So if you guys want to use a femoto cell in research, such as you want to hack a vehicle that with a cellular modem, well, you can just if you hack the femoto cell, just put it here and power on. Well, you can capture all the control command. Such as the SMS that contains that such as power on or something else that you can modify the traffic data and actually, some device that use the data traffic will know that if it's connected with a true or fake that base station. So this is a real base station. So you can bypass it. Well, and besides, the data traffic is all in your hands, so you can find your system's bugs, and now you can fix it or just hack it. So here is the point. How can we get a free femoto cell? Well, actually in China, a little bit difficult to buy one because according to some policy, they won't let you to buy it free. They just don't give you. Well, if you want to buy it, it's illegal. So we can't buy one, so let's just use some social engineering. In China, if you guys home that will have not good signals, well, you can just make phone call and complain to the customer's voice, and you will tell them, "Hi, lady, hi, ma'am, I just can't make a phone call out of, in my home. So what's going on?" And they will just, "Sir, maybe you can just turn off your phone and on again." So you can just make them call to again and again. Well, finally in the end, that you can make a complaint to the management department. So this department will just call them that, "Yeah, you should solve this problem." And finally, we received a phone call that, "Sir, please permit us to set up a femoto cell in your home, and it's free, and you can make your network signals quality better." So, well, we get it. So now we have one. So let's just hack it. And well, inside this femoto cell, there's about these things: home node B, router with Wi-Fi, and apparently, one port and two LAN ports. And here is the most important thing: that it's configuration IP, and the router's IP is 197.1, and the home node B configuration IP is 197.241. Well, you guys can see that absolutely the most important IP is the home node B IP, because this is the GSM signal that you can configure. So let's just a quick and simple port scan. Let's just map it. Yeah, we got a lot of we can see a lot of services that it offered. Some FTP, telnet, HTTP, and well, it seems something interesting that is WDB RPC. So let's just try easily things. So login or just telnet it. Well, it comes up to a prompt that vxworks login. Well, it seems vxworks operating system. So the first thing in our mind is just enemy router. Well, basically, it's wrong. And something interesting is the error password again. Well, you will get a longer and longer time between the prompt shows up. So let's forget about the brute force. So that doesn't work. Let's try it another way. Well, according to its vxworks, you can just get something new about it. It's a real-time operating system, and used a lot of in the military device, that medication device, and some or rocket, or just you know, Apple Airport Extreme. And well, of course, it's not open source, so it's hard to break it. And well, let's just Google it. It seems that a lot, just two ones that comes up. That so let's just try to. Another thing that if you guys focus on femoto cell before, and you will know that the last year and the year before the last year, also in Black Hat DefCon, they hacked femoto cell and they modified a lot. And it looks similar to this one, but here is the different things. That, most of the different things that theirs are Linux-based, and you can just write a module and get in here. But this is vxworks. It seems pretty hard. And this is a different, much harder. So let's use, remember the port that we just scanned, there will be a WDBRPC. So the past ones that will have the dump memory that just use the Kali and try it. Well, it seems this debug interface doesn't work. So, and of course, this exploit was written by Eddie Moore, so thank him. So, well, according to fail to use, fail in use, and just let's scan his version. Well, repair it again. So what's going on? Well, it seems it doesn't work, so we just try it another way. And we just disassemble this hardware and see what's chip in here and try to modify it and dump the firmware to analysis. And well, this is the two parts, the home node B and your router. The home node B is, of course, the OMAP chip, and it contains the DSP, the ARM9, and of course, FPGA. And the router is AR9341, and it got a router and one Wi-Fi IP. So, so if you guys want hacked an embedded device before, that you will know that almost lots of device will have a debug port on their board, so the developer can just develop and debug it through this port. So what we do is just to find it out, and well, it is. So it's just on the board, and it will tell you this is a debug board. It will say this is a TX, this is a RX. So you can just simply connect it with your laptop. So through an USB to server port, TTL signal adapter. So you just connect the board with your laptop. Well, it's just a gift. So of course, they give out gifts. So let's just use it. And it seems that a lot of information while this device is booting. And it says this is vxworks 6.8. Well, apparently it fixed a lot of bugs. And you can see there's just, since that it tell you print any key to stop output. Well, you can just press simple space. Well, it stopped and give us the most important thing, the vxworks boot shell. So now just use it. Thank you. So let's just, our nature just help or get this help list and see what commands we can use. And apparently some. If you see it, you will know some which one is important. Well, the boot params, the change boot params, and your load boot files, and well, of course, they have got some display memory, modify memory, fill memory, copy memory. Well, the memory is everything, right? So you can just let's take a quick use. And we just press P and enter. Well, here you got something out. We tried it. This command, this information means nothing. And let's see the directory structure. So we RS, and it comes out a lot of things. And apparently, I use days to see, which file it means what, and can we use it, and how large is it? The mostly basically most terrible things. It's really terrible. Yeah. And now I can tell you that this is the most important things that, my work. the TFS 0 is the directory structure, and the common is the configuration file, and the user one is the currently running the version that this vxworks system and your router and your JSON bird apps. And the user 2 is the last version. So here's the things. When this femoto cell upgrades, the last version firmware will remain on this bird. So if you guys a little bit of things is that if the bug is fixed, so you can just put in another structure, then it comes back again. Volume backup, this is the router firmware backup files. So we don't have a lot of way to hack it. So just dump its firmware and uncompress it and analyze it. So here's the thing that how do we download it? Now we should download the firmware. And remember we used the, we scanned out the TFTP port, just a simple, make a simple test. We upgrade, we upload, and we download. It works fine. So we know the path, and we just CP TFTP get, and one by one. You can just write a simple script. Don't like me. I just typed. So here is the thing that according to our work, that we know the mpc.z is the most important file that is the kernel image. So let's just compress it and disassemble it. Now, this is my colleague's work. Yuwei, got it?
Okay, and from the file name mpc.z, we can guess that it may be a compressed image. But, I use binwalk tool to try to find any information about the image type, and I got nothing. And after consult to the Google search, I found an article understanding the boot ROM image of vxworks. What is an intercept from the vxworks manual? In this article, some clues indicate that the vxworks image was compressed with deflate algorithm. But even though, with the deflate method from the lib, what I got was Android error. And I examined two versions of the image. We got the 0515.0100 from the header. The 4 bytes is fixed, maybe it's magic. And the next 4 bytes from the header is 0033CC67. And I guess it's a length, and verify that. This length plus 9 was the equal to the file length. And after we skip the first 9 bytes. Just use a tool, the leap fleet, to decompress it. And now, let's examine. Thank you. Now let me examine this image and use string to check if it have a lot of literal strings. Yes, it contains a lot of literal strings and it's a success. Now we can analyze the firmware. This image decompressed from the mpcs.z is raw binary. It's not the EIF image and it's not contain any information about the location and the linking information. And from the boot shell, we can use a command to load the mpc.z. We can see that this image has been loaded to say 0100000. This is the address the vxworks kernel executes from. And now, we can load the image to IDA Pro and just reload the image to address say 0100000. And currently, the assembly code is very difficult and our function name all unliteral. And to find the information is difficult. And after a lot of effort, we recover the symbol. And then I found the user security function is the entry where it's the user and the hash of password. It seems that it has been encoded by base 64. The hash has been encoded, and after decoder, we get a 32 binary. Now we must to find what's the hash method it used.
So sorry, our laptop got something wrong. Well, it's not ours. Well, now it's Windows. And it's Lenovo. Yeah, we were trying to bring out own laptop, but according to some policy, our laptop that can't come to America. Yeah, we should buy a Mac. Oh, it's power on. 我这个关掉。你要跳到哪个地方？
对。
Sorry, almost done.
It's just here.
Well, we are back.
Okay. Sorry. And we know that the MD5 is 16 bytes and SH1 is 20 bytes. And SH256 is 32 bytes. So we guess it's maybe hashed by SH256. And decoded with the online decoder website, we got the password is just 128. So always try 128 fast. But sometimes we don't always have good luck, and this topic we are sure a general method to bypass the password. And if the system does not use a weak password, what can we do? In fact, the new version of this firmware, they had changed the password, and the website can't decode it. And from the assembly code, we found that after the username and the password have been inputted, the hash computation function will be executed. And in this situation, in this function, use the IPCOM auth hash to compute the hash function, and use the IP auth hash get to get the original hash code, and then use the memcomp to compare the two. So we just patch this instruction and let it always grant to this address. Here we have to wait to patch it, and we may patch the firmware and the lib compress it and add the header, then download the file by TFTP and copy it to the user1 directory. But for simply, we can also use the hot patch method. And in the boot shell, first use the L command to load and decompress the mpc.z to the memory. And then we use M command to change this instruction from DFFF FFOA to DFFF FFEA. Exactly, we just patch the bcool instruction to b instruction. Now we can log in, use any password. We can get the vxworks kernel shell, and there are a lot of tools can be used. Here is the, we can get the main point, and let's capture the data traffic and try to analyze it. We can use a computer to share an internet link with Linux IP tables or Windows internet connection sharing service, or use a root with port mirror function. We can use the WireJack to capture the packet in real time now. Here is the data packet, but none of the data contains any literal text. What the hell is this? And we can use the WireJack tools to open the packet. Reopen it.
Well, how is opening the package? So you guys want, if you want to give a speech or a presentation, use your own laptop. Press here. Yeah, double click. 你先把这个，一会儿把这个 拖过来，因为它看不到。等这个关。So it's okay. Yes. Are you here?
Yeah.
Hi, we got it. So, 看你要不要拖一下。 Well, it's really hard to see. Yeah, okay, that's got it.
Yes, we got it. And we can see if in the packet.
Well, it's a big packet because we just captured 2 days and all our neighbors, SMS, we can all see, yeah.
Yes, the packet, but the packet is have a lot of error and the WireJack can't decode it. And you may see all packets have the malform. Okay. Maybe it's encrypted. And we use the IP, it's encrypted with the IPsec, and we can decrypt it. First, we resign the port from 500 to the SAKMP and 60 to 96 to UDP in CAPE. And now, add this password from the logger, we can decrypt it. But it's a wrong protocol, and as I show you on the WireShark. We request the image to find the which protocol we use it, and the vendor have changed the protocol. And while doing a lot of reverse work, we found that the IMP protocol exactly has been modified. And after decoding the protocol, we can analyze the short message, and one section of the IMP have been replaced with a protocol, and GPRS have been replaced with BSGP protocol. So we rewrite a WireShark decoder, and it can decode this packet correctly. This is the short message packet we captured. Currently, I will show you the.
We will show you the correct result. Yeah, here is my version Wireshark. You can download it, but you can't.
GSM SM 然后相划线 SMS
是不是拖着它们你可以先把它移过来然后再那个
Yeah, this package is so big. So our laptop can. Yeah, here it is.
双击，这是双击. Okay. Yeah.
Yes. It's here.
So here is the today. Oh, that's it. It seems our neighbor didn't send so much. Yeah. So much SMS. So let's just look at its detail.
Okay, we can see the detail of the short message packet now. And we can show you a video about it.
Wow, this, I mean, just show you some video that prove it. So, a moment. SMS, yeah. Well, here is the phone to sell. Oh, that's it. And besides that, that's my badge. Well, you guys know my phone number. Now you can hack me. Yeah, you can see the details that we just sent. And well, now we are capturing our package. The data grows. Yeah. And okay, just make a quick symbol. Yeah. Let's just tap the JSM/JSM. I'll wait a moment. Well, let's can see. Well, here it is. Now we can see the details. And of course, I got a video about how to capture the mail contents. But according to our time, yes, after time, yeah, we just consider. And also, we got a vendor area in the vendor area. So if you guys want to know something, that you can contact me with that, or you can in the end of the PowerPoint, well, they have my email, so you can just send an email or just let us know your questions. And my apologies for my accent. And according to some policy, we have deleted some important things that we are not willing to. And I'm really sorry about that. Yeah. And so if you guys want to know about it, just contact me in private. Okay. Yeah. There it is. Yeah, sure. Let me show you my email. Okay. Oh, where is? Oh, I see. Yeah, that's my name, and at 315.cn. That's okay. This is okay. You guys can find the PowerPoint, the PDF. They got something out here. Yeah. Here. Let's just go to the. Oh, sorry. I'm so rushed. Yeah. Yeah, here is the HTTP traffic. Yeah, you can know your neighbor is visiting some website. Yeah, here is our email and our password. Well, this site is just a basic America eBay. Yeah. Wow, this is the mail. Yeah. Well, this is a summary, and we got a lot of reference, and we are thanking. Yeah. Yeah, this is my email, and we got a vendor here at the Unicorn team that you can buy things or just ask me a lot of questions. So we're waiting for you. Hi, guys. Yeah. So, thank you.